want to run a quick survey. How many of you have ridden the MRT or LRT? Halos lahat ah. Sino naman po dito ang nakaranas na yung mga pagtitigil, yung mga problema ng MRT, LRT? Halos lahat rin. Okay. Kung kayo yung mga lucky ones na nakaka-experience ng mga problema ng MRT. You know, one of my pet peeves, I remember, when I was still in the private sector, is going to a government toilet. Have you tried that? No, well, pupunta kayo sa City Hall, or punta kayo, let's say, actually, NAIA, no? If you go to NAIA, you go to a government toilet, parating madumi at mabaho. No? Hindi ko maintindihan because if you cannot fix the toilet, how can you fix government? Diba? Actually, every time I read the papers and I see the news about the MRT, about NAIA, about traffic, parang sabi ko, parang yung problema ng ordinaryong Pilipino na kalimutan na ng gobyerno. No? Bakit yung mga maliliit at simpleng problema hindi masolusyonan ng ating gobyerno? Kung hindi natin masosolusyonan yung maliit na problema, paano pa yung problema ng ekonomiya natin at ng buong bansa? And then we talk about entrepreneurship. No? We always talk about small business, promoting entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship should be the backbone of this country. But if you have a small business and you go to City Hall and apply for your business permit, sigurado dalawang tao makakausap mo doon. Yung fixer, tama, no? Or yung empleyado na magiging fixer mo. No? So, that's why in Valenzuela, namin, no, when I assumed office, I told myself that the first order of business is to fix the small things, no? Like the banyo, no? The discipline among the employees, and promote entrepreneurship in City Hall. Because that's where the bulk of our businesses are. No? The small businesses, the sari-sari store, the tindera and the palengke, we have to help them lower down their business costs. So, this is Aling Ana. No? Aling Ana is probably a few thousand of sari-sari stores owner in Valenzuela. And I'm sure, you know, in the Philippines, this is, Aling Ana is probably the few millions of sari-sari store owners in the Philippines. And if you are a small business owner, there are three things that you have to apply in City Hall. You know? Your building permit, your real estate property taxes, and your business permit. So these are the three things that you have to apply in City Hall to run your business. And in the old process, there are many requirements. No? You have to go to the barangay, you have to go to your fire department to get your clearance. A daming requirements. And it's time consuming because you have to go to the different offices. It's also very, very confusing because especially when you apply for a building permit, you have to go jump from one table to the other, from your electrical permit, from your building permit, from your mechanical permit. And it's very frustrating. You know? So in the old process, you can see, makikita nyo dito, ito yung mga requirements na kailangan nyo just to start your business. You know? 7 requirements for your new business and 10 requirements to your renewal of business. And these are the steps. You know, you have to undergo 10 steps just to get your permit. So if you're a small sari-sari store owner, dapat dumaan ka ng 10 steps just to start your own small business. So in Valenzuela, we launched what we call the 3S Plus. No? Actually, 3S lang yan. And then the new mayor added this plus. First S is simple, in processes. Speed and delivery, service excellence, the plus is using technology. And let me just go through the 3S plus very, very quickly. The first S is simple. So we reduce the number of prerequisites if you apply for a business. You know, the common premise of government to the applicant is the applicant is always dishonest. So, dapat ipakita mo muna lahat ng mga requirement mo bago ka namin bibigyan ng permit. Pero in Valenzuela, we changed the whole concept. We assume that the applicant, or in this case, the sari-sari owner, store owner, is honest. So we give you, when you apply, we give you your permit right away, and within 30 days, you comply with the other requirements. So within a few minutes, you're up and running ready. Just to show you, in the old process, there are about 7 requirements, but we managed to reduce it to 3 requirements. There are statutory requirements by law that we cannot do away with. So, but kahit papaano, na-reduce na namin from 7 to 3 and from 10 to 3. The second S is speed. Speed is largely hinged on information technology. And this is very important. This is the heart and soul of the 3S Plus project, no? Using information technology. For all of our departments in City Hall, from the Treasury Department, from the Assessor Department, from the Business Permit Department, everything is linked. Dati pupunta ka from one office to the other just to get your permit. So here, you only talk to one person. And because of information technology, we managed to reduce the 10 steps earlier that I've shown you to only 4 steps. And before, when you apply for a permit, it takes about 14 to 21 days to get your permit. Now it only takes 20 minutes. So this is another another example of using technology. No? We use the graphical information system to improve our tax collection. Para tong Google Earth, no? If you've used Google Earth, so it's a satellite-based information system. In Valenzuela, kasi uso sa amin yung mga compounds. No? I don't know if anyone of you are from Valenzuela, but in Valenzuela, uso yung compounds. So you cannot see what they have inside their compounds, if they have how many houses, if they have how many factories. And the basis for your tax collection is the infrastructure or the asset that you have in your compound. So in the old process, we have to send our tax mapper, tawag namin dun tax mapper, to literally go there and measure each and every structure you have. Siyempre, alam mo naman yung mga taxpayer natin, pag medyo magaling sila, bibigyan ng kape, konting biscuit, diba? Konting envelope, no? Makakalimutan, mabubulag na yung tax mapper namin. Ano? So, we used the graphical information system. In this case, we eliminated human intervention. So, we don't have to send our tax mapper there to measure your infrastructure. We used a satellite-based system to know exactly what assets and what improvements do you have in your compound. So just to give you an idea, so using the satellite-based system, we will know exactly how big is your house or your factory. And we can compute right away how much you have to pay the government. So no human intervention. If you eliminate human intervention, you eliminate corruption. And we also, with the graphical information system, we also improve the process when you apply for your tax declaration. Before, it takes about 2 to 3 days to get your tax declaration. Now, it takes about 15 to 30 minutes na lang to get your tax declaration. And of course, you have to compute the return on investment because all of these technologies cost money. No, so we invested about 19 million in this technology. We have already collected about 215 million and we will be collecting another 338 million. So that's 11 times return on investment on this technology. So it's worth it. And the third S is service. And this is probably one of the most difficult part of the 3S because we're talking about humans. And alam niyo, mabilis bumili ng technology. You know, a lot, you can talk to a vendor, they'll sell you the technology. You know, you talk to a hardware vendor, they'll sell you the hardware. But you need your employees to implement this system. And this is the most difficult because a lot of the employees have been working in City Hall for many, many years. No? Iba dyan, 30 years. Iba dyan, 40 years. Iba dyan, actually, bata pa ako. When I go to City Hall before, when I was a kid, nakikita ko na sila doon. And when I became the mayor, nakikita ko pa rin sila doon. So, just imagine, a lot of these employees have been used to doing their own thing. So we have to change their mindset that the taxpayer is like our customer. No? And we have to change your mindset that the taxpayer is, we have to treat the taxpayer just like when the taxpayer, just like any other customer, no? In a hotel, in a restaurant. And we did that by constantly training our employees. Talagang binugbog namin sa training. In the hotel industry, the employees get trained there twice a year. No? There's a specific amount of hours for training. In Valenzuela, we did that also. And it's also very important to communicate with your customers, with your taxpayers. So in Valenzuela, we also use technology like Facebook, Twitter. So we get all the information right away. In fact, ako personally, kung binabasa lahat ng email ko, no, from our constituents, because it's important to get first-hand information. Nangyari kasi na, like for example, my email, I leave it to somebody else, minsan nasa-sanitize na eh. So it's important, no, pinag-tsatsagaan ko talaga to read each and every email that the constituents send me. And this is the third, this is the plus in the 3S plus. And this is actually one of the great innovations that the new mayor introduced. No? When you apply for a building permit, you know, you go to your building official, you fill up the form, you give up your plans, but that plans go to different engineering offices. No? It goes to the mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, but in this case, para na siyang ATM. No? So you just fill up your form, lagay nyo lang sa ATM yung plans nyo, and then the screen will tell you when to pick it up. No? So you don't have to talk to anybody, walang fixer, walang human intervention. Before it takes about 2 months to get your building permit, now it takes about 1 to 2 days, no? Assuming that you followed the building code tooth and nail. And of course, the proof is in the pudding. No? Lahat naman to dapat mag-translate into improvement. So, in the last 9 years, we managed to double our registered businesses by 100, double it and increase it by 100%. Our business permit income, we managed to increase it by 182%. Our real property taxes, we managed to increase it by 215%. The last 2 years is attributed to that GIS, that satellite-based information system. And overall income increased by 100% in the last 9 years. Of course, the more money you have, the more funds you have, the more projects you can do, and the more projects you can do, of course, you will have a happy customer. And before I end, you know, in the last 2 days, I think we have experienced heavy downpour, heavy traffic. No, and when I was scrolling through my Facebook, ang daming mga nagmumura, ang daming minumura si ganito, minumura si MMDA. Actually, MMDA ang perfect punching bag eh. Kaya kung meron kayong, kung ako ang presidente at meron akong kagalit na politiko, i-appoint ko yan kaagad sa MMDA. Tapos na yung political career niya. So anyways, I saw this hashtag. No? Mura, ganun, tapos hashtag hopeless Philippines. Medyo na-depress ako, no? Especially being a public servant. No? Sabi ko, parang hopeless na ba talaga ang Pilipinas? Wala na ba pwedeng mangyari sa atin? Well, in my experience, it's not hopeless yet. No? Maraming innovations happening around the country. There's a lot of new mayors, a lot of new governors, a lot of congressmen, and a lot of public servants are very sincere in coming up with solutions for our people, our country. So it's not hopeless, definitely. And we just have to do our part, first, by choosing the right leader. Kayo lahat, mga botante, it starts with you. You know? You choose the right leader, and then second, tell your friends to choose the right leader also. Because hindi naman pwede kayo lang. Dapat lahat tayo pumipili ng mga magagaling na leader, especially those ones who are creating solutions and innovations to help the country. So it's not hopeless. We remain hopeful. Thank you very much.